auch teilweise bei den Lehrgängen ein Verbot gehabt, Ballmaschinen zu machen.
Yes. In all national training camps, Ballmaschine was verboten. Mm-hmm. It was not allowed. In any kind of training, it was not allowed. All was for flying and shuttle.
Yeah.
And I'm quite sure it still is like that.
Yeah.
Maybe they sometimes do a little bit of physical training with Ballmaschine because that's really good. But the idea behind it is that they want the fastest players in the world on the court. So and the only way to do that also is to be able to anticipate, to read the situation, to understand what's going on. Because it's not only about the physical side, they can be strong enough. Some of the mid-single players from Denmark, or one of them again, is maybe one of the best physical players in the world. But that's not enough. If you don't know how to use it, then it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter you have a killer physique.
But you still talk about single players, right?
In all.
Yeah.
This is not only single training, it's in everything. It's all double, doesn't matter.
But it's also at the youth camps.
Yeah, it's the junior camps, it's not the grown-ups. They for sure they do a lot of Ballmaschine.
Yeah, but if you have a training camp with 15 players, mm-hmm. there will be no Multifilm.
No.
I can't agree on that story, but I have been on two or three national camps with Leonard and Klaus.
Then you have Jakob as well. You haven't been with one with me, I can tell
no,
you that.
Sure. No, but it's like, I don't know if it's a general idea we want on the flying shuttle. Maybe for this camp was the idea. I think it's a good idea to use the progression and the priority in a way relevant for the group. Like, example, I completely agree one shuttle would be always better if it's possible to happen, but if you have to overspeed and you don't have the players, how do you do that one? Like, example, or you want to start with the basics and you want to talk about recognition, of course you have to start with some kind of a progression altogether.
But the key is they are not just beginners.
That doesn't mean that it
works all the time. No, because for sure they have to learn to train like that. They don't understand it in the beginning.
Genau, und das ist der Unterschied zwischen dem deutschen und dem dänischen Nationalcamp. Mm-hmm. Ne? Weil das dänische Nationalcamp unterhält sich nicht mehr über Prinzipien.
Yeah, and of course, maybe you've seen some of the other coaches do it, but I would say, in general, the 7 years I worked there, mm-hmm. and all the camps I was to, the multi-feeding, it was less than 1% of all the time. It happened for sure, and it's not like if it really do not work for the players and they cannot understand what we're trying to change, then this is also a solution that we do this at one point, but we don't start there. And we try to avoid it as much as we can.
I understand the idea completely. I agree with the idea. It's not about that one. It's just about the level where we are according to what we can do at the moment.
There's more to it because if you have a junior camp in Denmark, let's say under 15, then they have, or had, maybe they changed it the last few years, but then we had 3 weekend camps and 1 summer camp of 7 days. This is all the time they train together. Yeah. So in the entire year, then we had so little time with the players. What they did in the clubs, what they did at some of the centers around Denmark, for sure was different.
Sure.
It was a lot different.
Ich glaube, das, worum es ja letztendlich geht, ist, die Spieler da abzuholen, wo sie sind, aber sie auf jeden Fall in das nächste Level zu bringen. Und das heißt, ich muss den Spieler, er muss sich anpassen. Und das heißt, ich muss eigentlich schauen, dass ich immer ein Level höher trainiere, als da, wo er ist. Weil wenn ich da trainiere, auf dem Level, wo er ist, dann wird er sich nicht von sich aus weiterentwickeln zum nächsten Level.
Ja.
Und so diese Idee ist zu sagen, okay, ich beginne mit dem fliegenden Ball, ich versuche ihn dahin zu kriegen. Wenn ich merke, es geht gar nicht, weil das Prinzip des Schlages gar nicht funktioniert und der Laufarbeit, dann sage ich, okay, komm, einen Schritt zurück. Jetzt müssen wir einmal schauen, dass wir die Prinzipien verstehen.
Yeah, that's all. If they are too tired to do it physically, because the intensity goes up
mm-hmm.
in the exercises. So when they get too tired, then okay, we can go back.
Yeah.
But we start with the flying shuttle, not with the multi.
Wir probieren sie in das nächste, eigentlich auf die nächste Ebene zu bringen. Und das heißt, wir trainieren eigentlich immer ein bisschen schneller oder ein bisschen anfordernder als da, wo sie sind. Wenn wir merken, es funktioniert nicht, entweder aufgrund der Tatsache, dass sie müde werden oder aufgrund der Tatsache, dass Prinzipien nicht verstanden worden sind, dann gehen wir diesen einen Schritt zurück. Und dann klar gibt es dann auch Ballmaschinen und besonders im jüngeren Bereich, auf jeden Fall auch isoliertes Techniktraining. Aber ich schaue, dass ich sozusagen diesen Mono-Shuttle-Bereich, wo ich mit fliegendem Ball arbeite, so hoch halte, wie es geht, weil dann nämlich genau dieses Wahrnehmungstraining, wo ich lerne, Bewegungen zu lesen, wo ich Situationen lese, wo ich ein viel, viel authentischeres Feedback über meine eigenen Schläge bekomme, das ist aus Ballmaschinen, da kann ich 10 Bälle ins Netz schlagen und 10 Bälle ohne Winkel ins Hinterfeld hauen, ich bekomme trotzdem aus der Ballmaschine den nächsten hohen Ball. Das ist viel schwieriger zu simulieren, als wenn ich das mit fliegendem Ball mache.
And then we also did a very short time. Or they do it very short time. That means if they do an exercise with the shuttle, sometimes the shuttle will stay, it could go on for minutes if you allow the players. But we would always make sure that put a timer on and make sure it never went over a minute. Because then the quality falls, then it goes too slow.